Welcome to the National Healthcare Safety Network, or NHSN, Hot Topic Session. This presentation will provide you with updates on reporting on bloodstream infection, or BSI, definition changes for 2015. This presentation focuses on changes to 2015 protocol for BSI. The full protocol is available on the NHSN website. You should review the hot topic on definitional changes prior to reviewing any protocol. This webinar contains guidance for properly applying new rules and definitions for date of event, repeat infection timeframe, or RIT, and secondary bloodstream attribution period, all of which are used during BSI surveillance for NHSN reporting. A short webinar can be found at cdc.gov/nhsn/training. So why update the BSI definitions for 2015? The Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS, quality improvement programs, along with state mandates, have prompted careful review of criteria for healthcare-associated infections, or HAIs, and other reportable events. CDC's assessment of NHSN, coupled with feedback from system users and subject matter experts, have led to important changes in definitions, criteria, and business rules. These updates aim to increase consistency in reporting, update surveillance definitions, and streamline secondary BSI reporting. Neither the laboratory-confirmed bloodstream infection, LCBI, criteria, nor the mucosal barrier injury, MBI-LCBI, have any criterion changes for 2015. Let's look at what's new. Surveillance definitions for specific types of infections have been updated to reflect current practices and may affect when a BSI is attributed to another primary site. New changes are detailed in the Hot Topic Definitions presentation. Please review for clarity. Date of event is updated to reflect the date when the first element used to meet the criterion occurs for the first time in the 7-day infection window. Gap days are no longer used to determine fulfillment of infection criteria. Instead, the NHSN infection window is used to make this determination. The NHSN infection window is defined as the 7-day period during which all site-specific infection criterion must be met. It includes the day the first positive diagnostic test included as part of the site-specific infection criterion was obtained, and the 3 calendar days before and 3 calendar days after. Diagnostic tests could include the laboratory specimen collection date, imaging test date, procedure or exam date, physician diagnosis, or initiation of treatment. Here is an example of how to identify the infection window and set the date of event. The blood culture on day 13 sets the center point of the infection window. The infection LCBI-2 definition is met, and hospital day 11 is the date of event. The date the first element, fever, is used to meet the LCBI-2 criterion occurs for the first time within the 7-day infection window period. Let's now move on to the next definition, secondary BSI attribution period. This is the period in which a positive blood culture must be collected to be considered secondary to a primary site infection. This period includes the infection window period combined with the RIT. This period is 14 to 17 days depending on the date of event. Note that a primary BSI does not have a secondary BSI attribution period. Let's look at this symptomatic UTI or SUTI example. The date of event for this SUTI is hospital day 11. The secondary BSI attribution period encompasses both the infection window period and the RIT. In this example, the BSI attribution period is 15 days in length. This includes the 14 days of the RIT and one additional day of the infection window period. The length of the secondary BSI attribution period depends on the date of event. It is, however, never greater than 17 days. Secondary BSIs may be attributed to a primary site infection if either of the following is true. The positive blood culture pathogen matches at least one organism found in the site-specific infection culture used to meet the primary site infection criterion. Or, the positive blood culture is an element used to meet the primary site infection criterion. Let's return to the SUTI example. A blood culture with a collection date on hospital day 18, a day that is included in the secondary BSI attribution period, is positive with a pathogen that matches at least one organism found in the urine culture. Therefore, the final determination is a SUTI with a secondary BSI, pathogen E. coli, and date of event, day 11. Appendix 1, Secondary BSI Infection Guide, should continue to be used to determine appropriate attribution of secondary BSIs. Remember, primary site-specific criteria, as defined in the CDC NHSN Surveillance Definitions for Specific Types of Infection, Chapter 17, must be met first in order to apply the secondary BSI guidance. The first guidance to consider is whether there is at least one matching organism for both the blood and the site-specific culture. If the blood and site-specific cultures do not match, but the positive blood culture is an element used to meet the primary site infection criterion, then the BSI is considered secondary to the primary site-specific infection. If the site-specific criteria does not use the blood culture as an element to meet the criteria, and the organisms do not match, then a primary BSI must be identified. Logical pathogens have been removed from the protocol and are not considered. Also recall that the site-specific infection would only be reported if it is a part of your facility's plan and/or required by your state. Use this algorithm to assist in making determinations. Remember that both the site-specific criteria and LCBI criteria must be met in order to consider a bloodstream infection as secondary to another primary source. The final topic is the assignment of pathogens when reporting infections to NHSN. If additional pathogens are identified within an RIT and found to be associated with the event, those pathogens are added, and a new infection is not reported. In 2015, for some infection types, there are pathogen exclusions. For example, certain designated organisms are not available for meeting the infection criteria for UTI and pneumonia definitions. Pathogens excluded from specific infection definitions also cannot be assigned as secondary BSI pathogens for those types of infections. Excluded pathogens must be attributed to either a secondary BSI for another site-specific infection or a primary BSI. For more details related to excluded pathogens, refer to the UTI and pneumonia Hot Topic presentations. So let's look at these two pathogen assignment rules. In this example, a urine culture is collected on day 18, which is within the SUTI repeat infection timeframe. A new pathogen, Enterococcus, is identified. Because the culture was collected within the SUTI repeat infection timeframe and Enterococcus is an eligible pathogen, it is assigned to the originally reported SUTI. Additionally, a blood culture collected during the SUTI secondary BSI attribution period, hospital day 14, was found to be positive with pathogens E. coli and C. albicans. Because C. albicans is an excluded pathogen for the UTI definition, it cannot be assigned as a secondary BSI to the SUTI. Instead, other primary sources for the C. albicans BSI must be considered according to the secondary BSI guide. If another site-specific infection is not identified for which the BSI can be secondary, then the BSI meets criteria for a primary LCBI. Note the date of event for the primary BSI, hospital day 14, is also the date of the positive blood culture. This is day one of the 14-day RIT for the primary BSI. During this time frame, no new primary BSI is reported. The final determination represented on this slide is a SUTI with a secondary BSI. Pathogens include E. coli and Enterococcus, and the date of event is hospital day 11. Additionally, an LCBI has been identified with pathogen C. albicans, and the date of event is day 14. Another concept to discuss relates to the assignment of a pathogen to more than one infection source. Depending on federal, state, and local reporting requirements, a secondary BSI pathogen may be assigned to two different primary site infections, for example, a UTI and an IAB infection. In this example, a pathogen is assigned as a secondary BSI pathogen to two different primary infection sites, UTI and non-surgical IAB. Two primary site infections have been identified and a blood culture collected on day 17, which is within both the SUTI and the non-surgical IAB secondary BSI attribution period, has a matching pathogen to both primary site infections. Therefore, both primary sites are reported to have a secondary BSI. The final determination is a SUTI with secondary BSI, pathogen E. coli, date of event, hospital day 11, and a non-surgical IAB with secondary BSI, pathogen E. coli, date of event, hospital day 9. Let's look at another scenario. A SUTI is identified with hospital day 11 as the date of event. On hospital day 17, a blood culture is positive for E. coli, matching the SUTI pathogen. In accordance with a secondary BSI guide in Appendix 1, the BSI is determined to be secondary to the SUTI. Note the blood culture collection on hospital day 17 also occurred within the RIT of a primary BSI. E. coli pathogen is assigned to the LCBI. The result is identification of an LCBI with pathogens Staph aureus and E. coli and a date of event on hospital day 9. In conclusion, familiarize yourself with the new terminology and definitions before applying protocols. Identify your infection window and set your date of event to determine your RIT. If another primary infection source is considered for a BSI, then the site-specific definition must be met and secondary BSI guidance must be applied before calling a BSI secondary to another primary source. Apply the pathogen assignment guidance as needed. This concludes the NHSN Hot Topic Update, focusing on reporting changes for BSI protocol. Additional resources can be found on the NHSN website. For other questions, please contact NHSN User Support at nhsn@cdc.gov.